when we finally did get into A&M Records, it took Herb Alpert, who was a musician, and not, he's the musician half of the A&M. He's not the business half. And he saw what he liked musically in it and didn't stop to think whether it would sell or not. He just took us.
So everybody went their own way. Karen and I started doing the stuff ourselves, overdubbing all the voices ourselves rather than have other people. They thought, nothing's ever going to happen, like in New Haven, Connecticut.
Yeah,
so
we,
you know, we got to get home.
Right.
Yeah, that was home.
Right.
Yeah.
They just wanted to be in a surroundings where it might have happened easier.
When you come in to do a concert, you you run in and you're in there for like a rehearsal during the afternoon, and nobody is usually allowed into the rehearsals. And then you go get dressed and you do the show, and then zoom. You know, you're either gone right away or else you're in the dressing room doing interviews. And
they still live at home with their parents in the not especially fashionable community of Dunphy.
After a brief look around the house, Richard talked with obvious pride about the Carpenters' success.
Well, I guess I could ask, are you a millionaire?
Yeah, we are.
You say we are. Are you a millionaire?
Yeah, Karen, and both.
Separately?
Yeah. Separately.
Not together.
No.
You don't have to pool to be a...
No.
Though millionaires, they were not ostentatious. Karen's bedroom wasn't fancy, just thoroughly feminine, home to a menagerie of stuffed animals and Disney memorabilia. Richard's room was exceedingly sparse. The only room that was extensively outfitted was their in-home studio.
We've got quadraphonic sound. That's the newest thing, four-channel stereo, you know. It's about 125 watts per channel.
Karen took the opportunity to respond to critics who accused Richard of producing blatantly commercial music.
That's one of the things that people think. You know, they say, how did you figure out where to aim, and you know, to sell records? And that's one thing you can't do.
They thought it was a master plan, you know.
Yeah, they do, and it's not. It doesn't happen that way, because you just, what we did was, when we finally did get a chance to cut a record, we just did what we felt we could do the best, and what came, the arrangement that came out of his head.
Though relaxed and competent, Richard and Karen were stunned by their sudden success. Richard struggled to explain the Carpenters' appeal.
I'm sure there's some people who would think that, there's some people who think I look like a hippie. I mean, they're that square, that they think that I look wild, or, you know, that we sing rock and roll music just because we have guitar amplifiers.
Yeah.
Then there's other people that think that we're so square that they don't believe how we can exist. But there are people of all ages that, you know, that we do appeal to.